वेलकम बैक गाइज, होप यू डूइंग वेल। अगेन वेलकम बैक टू द सेम सेशन दैट इज पावर एम्पलीफायर। सी वी हैड दिस, नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद क्लास ए, डायरेक्ट कपल पावर एम्पलीफायर। आई एम सेइंग डायरेक्ट कपल बिकॉज दिस रजिस्टर वी रेफरिंग इट एज एन कलेक्टर रजिस्टर, नाउ इट इज लोड फॉर अस एंड दैट लोड इज डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड टू द कलेक्टर। So you can replace this load with a loudspeaker. As it's a power amplifier, the load resistance is very low. You connect a loudspeaker of 4 ohms, 8 ohms. So this basically RC is load for me now. And load is directly connected to the collector. So that's why I'm referring it as a direct coupled amplifier. If it is coupling, don't think about this capacitor why I've connected. Just think that load is connected to the collector directly, and that's why I'm calling it as a direct coupled amplifier. Now see, this RB is connected. RB is what we know, that RB is a parallel combination of R1 and R2. You can connect this R1 separately and R2 separately. Connect R1 at the upper side, connect R2 at the lower side, and draw the same circuit diagram as we had in RC coupled amplifier. RC coupled voltage amplifier, you can draw the same diagram because it is a same circuit diagram of common emitter RC coupled single stage amplifier. Yes, it is same, except instead of a large value of resistor, now we have a small value of resistance as a load. You can connect a loudspeaker, clearly I am telling you. See, as it is a class A type, Q point is exactly at the center. See, Q point is exactly at the center, and that's why input and output waveforms are getting full swing across the line. Now this Q point shifts from center towards the maximum and from center towards the minimum. We know the basic amplification theory, is it? How the transistor amplifier works. I know you know very well how transistor amplifies the signal, but still, as the topic of load line is here in front of us, so let's discuss about the amplification process once again. Those who forgot or can't remember, for them, let's discuss that again. Amplification. See, Q point is exactly at the center. What is the Q point? Q point means it's minimum voltage and current available at the output of an amplifier without connecting an input signal. So even if I don't apply this input signal, then also ICQ current and VCQ, means current which is equals to ICQ and voltage up to VCQ, is available at the output without any input signal. Why it is available? Obviously just because of biasing that we have provided. So when you bias the transistor, some current and some voltage is available at the output. That current and voltage we refer it as ICQ and VCQ, is it? And those current voltage points a quiescent current and quiescent voltage, what we call it as an operating point, biasing point, or Q point simply. But now we kept this Q point exactly at the center for voltage amplifiers. Here also in class A direct coupled, we are keeping it as a center. But what's the motto behind keeping this as a center for voltage amplifiers? Because I want a full swing for the current, I want full swing for the voltage. That's what. I told you in the last semester that you compare that amplification action with the amplitude modulation. What is amplitude modulation? See, amplitude of a carrier signal changes with respect to the modulating signal. Is it? So modulating signal controls the change in the carrier signal amplitude. It is clear? Is it? Who is changing? Carrier signal. Is it? According to modulating signal. It means the change in the carrier is controlled by the modulating signal. Actually, modulating signal changes. We are getting modulated signal. Is it? From the carrier, basically. Who is changing? Carrier is changing. Actually, modulating signal changes? No. Modulating signal is maybe a my voice signal. It is changing? No, it is not changing. With reference to that modulating signal, carrier signal changes. Right? So amplifier is like that. See, if I apply some input voltage. According to the change in input, this current from supply changes. You see, if input voltage increases, obviously input current increases. So if input voltage increases, transistor will turn on and it will take more current from VCC. If input voltage decreases, transistor will go off, it will take less current from the supply. It means from where I am taking the current? From supply. Is it? So it means this current is my carrier signal and this is my modulating signal. Is it? That current amplification or the current increment or decrement is controlled by the input signal. Is it not? This is basic amplification of it. When you apply input signal, look at this. This is input signal. When you apply input signal, what will happen? Q point shifts upside. See, input voltage increases in this direction, Q point shifts upside. So Q point is shifting upward. It means this line basically is shifting towards the zero. Is it? It means Q point shifts up. This line goes here. Input voltage is now decreasing. Is it? Output voltage is decreasing. Input voltage increasing, output voltage decreases. Yes, we know that. It's a 180 degree phase shift. Look at this waveform and this waveform. This waveform is increasing, this waveform is decreasing. Because it's a common emitter and obviously it has to show 180 degree phase shift. We know that common emitter amplifier gives us 180 degree phase shift between input and output. If input increases, output decreases. Is it? Input decreases, output increases. I'm talking about the voltage, not about the current. See, if it is current, then input voltage increases, output current also increases. Input voltage decreases, output current decreases. Okay. So this is small input voltage that I have applied. Input voltage increases, output current also increases towards the maximum value, depend on the VCC. Right. Now see, input voltage increases, output voltage decreases. Output voltage decreases and it will reach at the max zero value. If input voltage is decreasing, output voltage will increase and it will attain maximum value of VCC. Can output voltage go beyond VCC? It is possible in amplifier. Output voltage. It is possible for output voltage to go beyond VCC? No, it's not possible. Output voltage cannot go beyond VCC. It will go maximum up to VCC. Yes, it's a common sense. We know that. Isn't it? Output voltage never cross VCC. So maximum it will go up to VCC, again it will come to its original position, that is Q position. That again it will go to minimum, again go to the original position. So this voltage is output voltage, that is minimum output voltage, and this is maximum output voltage. Maximum output voltage will be VCC, minimum output voltage will be zero. And here also, if this is the Q synth line or Q line or ICQ line, then current will increase maximum up to IC max that I am referring to, but it will be maximum twice of ICQ. This line is ICQ, so this will be ICQ. So this plus this will be ICQ plus ICQ, it means it is twice ICQ. So peak to peak value of current waveform will be twice of ICQ. Now here, in case of voltage, how much peak to peak value of voltage? 0 and VCC. Maximum minus minimum, if I do, then this to this peak to peak value will be 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4 up to VCC. Right? And what is peak to peak value of current? Here, if it is minimum value or 0 value, then 0, 1, 2, 3, here it is ICQ. Obviously, the strength of negative half cycle will be exactly equal to the positive half cycle. Equal swing. Why? Because Q point is at the center. So equal swing means this is ICQ. So upper part will be exactly equal to ICQ. It means ICQ plus ICQ. It means peak to peak current will be twice of ICQ. Is it not? I'm referring it as an IC max and IC minimum. So IC max minus IC minimum will be twice ICQ. And VO max minus VO min will be V peak to peak, which is equal to VCC. This is what class A direct coupled amplifier. Can we start with the analysis? That part is, I hope it is clear. See, I'm telling you, it's not mandatory to draw the circuit diagram exactly like this. See, you can replace this RC with a loudspeaker. Instead of RB, you can connect R1 at upper side here, exactly at the place of RB, and you can connect R2 here. Yes, we can. It's possible. It means the circuit diagram of class A direct coupled amplifier is quite same as single stage RC coupled amplifier. Yes, it is, except instead of RC, connect a loudspeaker. Is it? We know the basic amplification action. It is a simple voltage amplifier like. Why? Because key point is at the center. We are used to that. Now, let's analyze this. Analysis of class A direct coupled amplifier. See, to analyze any power amplifier means eventually we have to calculate four parameters. Four parameters means how much input power I am taking. From where we are taking input power? V means power amplifier. From where power amplifier is taking input power? It is taking input power from VCC. So how much input power I am taking, how much output power I am developing or delivering to the load, whatever it is. How much input I am taking, how much output I am generating, and in the process of taking input and generating output, what is the efficiency? What is my efficiency? What is the amplifier's efficiency to generate the output voltage? Is it? That is third parameter. Fourth parameter is power dissipation. See, I am taking input, I am generating output. So in the process of taking input and generating output, there must be some wastage of power. That wastage is nothing but dissipation. Is it power dissipation? Generally in electronic circuit, power is dissipated in the form of heat. We know that. So four parameters are there. Analysis of amplifier means four parameters. How much I am taking, how much I am generating, in the process what is the efficiency, and in the process what is the wastage, what is the dissipation. Is it? So taking power from VCC. It is not taking power from the VCC. So it is DC power. Generating power is an AC power that we supposed to generate. Is it? Amplifier supposed to generate AC power from DC power. Is it? From DC we have generated AC. Is it? Why I am saying that I am generating AC? Because this is a controlled power that is controlled by input signal. Look at this. DC I am taking, generating AC. The generating AC means it is a controlled output. Who is going to control? That input is going to control. Is it? So eventually, what is the conclusion? Conclusion: analysis of a class A amplifier or analysis of any power amplifier has only four parameters. How much power I am taking, how much power I am generating in the process, what is the efficiency, and what is the wastage. Is it? Now, let's have this first point. Input DC power. How much DC power I am taking? See, I am taking power from VCC. It means I am taking DC power. So how much DC power I am taking? I am taking DC power equals to VCC multiplied by ICQ. Obviously, VCC multiplied by ICQ. ICQ is what basically it is a current at the output of an amplifier without any input signal. So that much power is available for us. As means for an amplifier. So that much power I am taking from the VCC. Is it? VCC multiplied by ICQ. P is equals to VI. P is equals to, what is that P? P is equals to V multiplied by I. V is what? My VCC, a complete voltage available. C means ICQ that we have decided. Is it? So that much input power I am taking from VCC. So this is the input DC power to my amplifier. Now second parameter is output power. How much output power amplifier has generated or developed. Is it? As it's an AC power, so obviously this RMS term will come in picture. Is it? Because it's an AC. So write RMS value. RMS value means what? See, VO RMS, PAC means output AC power is equals to RMS value of output voltage multiplied by RMS value of output current. Is it? Now here RMS value means Vm divided by root 2 and IORMS means Im divided by root 2. Im means and Vm is what? It is a peak value. Look at this. This from this point to this point is what Vm. What we call it as peak value. Is it? And from this point it is peak to peak. Look at this. This is peak to peak. So obviously 1/2 cycle is peak value. This is what Vm. Is it? Vm by 2. So root 2 and Im by root 2. Multiplication gives us Vm Im divided by 2. alternatively what I can write, see, I know VMIM divided by 2, VMIM divided by 2, VM means peak value. So peak value means half of peak to peak. Peak value means half of peak to peak. Yes, is it not? So peak to peak divided by 2. Here also I peak to peak divided by 2. Simplified, I will get VO peak to peak, IO peak to peak divided by 8. Now, the values of this VO peak to peak and IO peak to peak from the graph itself. Graph means DC load line. Look at this. VO peak to peak means I am talking about this voltage. How much is this? It is a VCC. We know that. But still, write an equation. This VO peak to peak means VO max minus VO minimum. And IO peak to peak means IO max minus IO minimum. Is it? This minus this will give me complete value. And this minus this will give me complete value. So VO max minus VO minimum. Look at this. VO max minus VO minimum. And IO max minus IO minimum. That's what my equation is. Agreed? So alternatively, what is out? How much output power generated by the amplifier? It is VMIM by 2. It clearly means VO peak to peak, IO peak to peak divided by 8. It means VO max minus VO means multiply by IO max minus IO minimum divided by 8. Is that? This is what? Power generated at the output. Now, third parameter is efficiency. See, first parameter is how much DC power I have taken, how much AC power I have generated. Now, in the process, what is the efficiency? Efficiency is what? Output divided by input. Is it? A common thing, efficiency. Efficiency of rectifier, efficiency of amplifier is what? Output power divided by input power is what? My efficiency. Output power means what? AC power that I have generated. Input power means DC power that I have taken. Is it? For example, I have taken 10 watts, I have generated 6 watts. From 10 watts, I have generated 6 watts. Is it? So, 6 watt divided by 10 watt multiplied by 100 is the efficiency. Is it not? Output divided by input multiplied by 100. General equation. Now, what is that PAC? It is output power. We know the equation of PAC. What is the equation of PAC? Look at this. VO max minus VO min. IO max minus IO min divided by 8 is the equation for PAC. What is equation for PDC? Equation for PDC is VCC minus ICQ. That's what it is. So VCC multiplied by ICQ. So put those value of PAC and PDC in the equation. If I put this, then what is the VO max minus VO minimum? VO max minus VO minimum, it is VCC. I know that. It is VCC. And VO minimum, look at this, VO max is VCC, VO minimum is 0, IO max, this IO max is equals to what? From 0 to this, twice ICQ. And what about this IO minimum? It is 0. So if I put this value of VCC, ICQ in the above equation, so VCC minus 0, put this value VCC and twice ICQ in above equation, then VO max minus VO minimum, that is VCC minus 0 multiplied by twice of ICQ minus 0. Look at this, 8 multiplied by VCC ICQ will remain as it is. If I put this value, what I am getting? Twice of VCC ICQ divided by 8 of VCC ICQ. It means it is 1 by 4 multiplied by 100 to get in percent. I am getting 25%. So 25% is the efficiency of class A direct coupled amplifier. Is it? So this is theoretically proven that efficiency is 25%. Practically, if you mount that circuit on a breadboard, you will get 10 to 15% only. Is it? So this is about efficiency. Yes. Till now, how much input power I have taken, how much output power I have generated, and what is the efficiency? That's what it is. Now, after that, it is power dissipation. Is it? So if it is power dissipation, then, sorry guys, hope you understand that I am at home. Now, power dissipation, the fourth point is power dissipation. Now, power dissipation means what? How much I have generated minus how much I am taking. For example, see, I am taking 10 watt, I am generating only 6 watt. What is the difference, or what is the dissipation? How much I am wasting? See, I am taking 10 and delivering only 8 or maybe 6. So difference is what waste. Is it? So PDC means how much I am taking minus how much I am generating. It's a clear subtraction. A difference between taken and generated is what dissipation is. It? So dissipation basically all in all electronic circuit, power dissipation dissipated in the form of heat only. Yes, we are not going into the detail of that, where the power exactly dissipated and how much the dissipation of every component in the amplifier. For the time being, just understand that power dissipation is what DC minus AC. Right? And power dissipation is maximum when input signal is zero. So let me justify this. Power dissipation is maximum when input signal is zero. Obviously, if input signal is not there, input means a controlling signal. Remember, amplitude modulation, it is a modulating signal. Is it? If modulating signal is absent, the what is the role of carrier then? Obviously, carrier has no role. I am not getting any controlled output. Is it? So if input is not there, output will not be there. So if there is no output, means there is no PAC. No input, no output, no PAC. So if PAC is not there, power dissipation will be equals to power taken, that is DC. So if PAC is absent, then PD is equals to PDC, that is DC power. So that's why we are saying power dissipation is maximum when there is no input signal. Maximum means how much? Exactly equals to PDC. So power dissipation maximum is equals to PDC. What is the value of PDC? It is VCC multiplied by ICQ. So PD max is equals to VCC multiplied by ICQ. So that much is okay for direct coupled amplifier. So analysis of direct coupled amplifier, what we have seen, how much power we have taken? We have taken VCC multiplied by ICQ. Then how much we have generated? We have generated VMIM divided by 2. That much AC power I have generated. Is it? In the process, theoretically, how much efficiency I am getting? I am just getting 25% efficiency. And how much power dissipation? DC power minus AC power is what my dissipation is. It? In next lecture, we will start with transformer coupled power amplifier. Is it? We'll take a short break and then we'll continue with transformer coupled amplifier. Thanks a lot.